My name is Christine Brown. I'm a professor at City of Hope, and I co-direct the CAR T-cell program. What CAR T-cell therapy is a way of re-engineering a patient's immune system and establishing new anti-tumor immunity. And we do this by programming a patient's T-cells, which are specialized white blood cells, to express a unique receptor that reprograms them to recognize and hopefully destroy the patient's tumor. I started 17 years ago at City of Hope when CAR T-cell therapy was really at the initial stages. Just in the last few years, this therapy has been now approved by the FDA. And now at City of Hope, what we're trying to do is extend this therapy to many different cancer types. And my program in particular is focused on brain tumors. City of Hope now is treated more patients with brain tumors with CAR T cells than any other institution in the world. We have two clinical trials that are enrolling patients in glioblastoma and soon to open two more. We've just opened a clinical trial in prostate cancer and are the only institution treating patients with breast cancer where their tumors have metastasized to the brain. And so we're really excited about where we stand at this point, and we believe that moving forward there's so much to be learned and gained, not only scientifically but for our patients. You know, when I think about what we have learned and gained scientifically and for our patients over the past decade, CIRM has been that critical partner that's allowed us to accelerate the vision of CAR T-cell therapy for patients with brain tumors. As we know, brain tumors, and especially glioblastoma, are some of the most intractable tumors and difficult to treat, just not responding to therapy. These tumors inevitably recur after standard of care, and new and innovative approaches are desperately needed. So at City of Hope, we believe CAR T cells have the potential to be an important part of a new approach for treating brain tumors that hopefully are more specific, with less toxicity, and most importantly, more effective, really giving patients not just months, but years and hopefully decades. Our partnership with CIRM began in the early preclinical stages of this project. Our research revealed that memory T cells with stem-like properties of self-renewal and lineage-specific differentiation generate more potent CAR T cell products. With CIRM support, we optimized and rapidly translated new CAR T cell approaches for glioblastoma, which have really set the foundation for our program initiating five new trials in GBM with three different CAR constructs. You know, as I reflect on what our team at City of Hope is trying to accomplish and create together in partnership with CIRM, I think it's our patients that say it best. So if you'll allow me to read a few quotes from patients, you know, our patients say that these therapies that CIRM is helping to support really gives them hope. A patient wrote and said, "I decided it was time to take a personalized approach to fighting this thing. Discovering I was eligible to participate in this trial was absolutely wonderful and gave me a feeling of hope." These therapies also give patients the cutting-edge care they need. Another patient wrote us saying, "This type of treatment is so cutting-edge. It's an overwhelming time, but we feel lucky to access this type of innovative care." And hopefully, these therapies give patients the critical time that they need. A wife of another patient emailed us and said her husband, after he finished six infusions of CAR T cells that were delivered at the site of his tumor and into his CSF, went hang gliding, which was something he had always wanted to do. Unfortunately, we learned that his tumors had come back, but actually in a different part of his brain. And his wife wrote, "The doctors here are intrigued that the original tumor site looks clear and wonder if the CAR T cells are keeping it in check." We can only hope so. You know, our program's motto is until we find a cure, our work is not done. And I know that motto probably resonates with a lot of individuals. And so my team and I at City of Hope are incredibly grateful for the vision and support of CIRM and for the groundbreaking stem cell-based therapies that they help bring to patients.
My name is Saul Priceman. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Hematology at City of Hope, and I develop immunotherapy in a way that allows your body's own immune system to fight cancer. I take a defective immune system and try to rewire it so that it can see the cancer again and attack it. You have trillions of cells in your body, and at any time one of those cells may go haywire, may be infected by a virus, may turn into a cancer cell, and your immune system has to recognize that. One of the immune cells in your body that sees and kills those rogue cells is a T cell. T cells roam through your body at all times, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, looking for bad guys, and they do that effectively. That's why we clear viral infections, other infectious diseases, and also why, for the most part, we clear cancers. Any of us will have maybe hundreds or thousands of cancers that are in our bodies from the day we're born till the day we pass, and your immune system has fought it off before it became symptomatic. Tumor cells have evolved a way to mask themselves from the immune system. So the normal mechanisms by which a virally infected cell or a cancer cell would present itself to the immune system to say, I'm here and I'm bad, they've suppressed those mechanisms. We've learned what allows a T cell to recognize a virally infected cell or a cancer cell. It uses very specific molecular signals inside the cell that says, I see something I don't like, and now I'm going to engage it and actively kill that cell. We've used that knowledge to engineer T cells, but direct it towards a target that we decide we want that T cell to target. So when a T cell that we develop sees a cancer cell, it will initiate that cascade of events, ultimately leading to killing that tumor cell. What we're doing is teaching that T cell how to do its job again, that if we put those back into the same patient, they will now be able to identify a cancer cell with higher success rate. They're going anywhere and everywhere in the body, and they're looking for that particular protein on a cell that we've taught it to see. We're going after proteins that are uniquely expressed by a cancer cell, and so they should pass right by a normal cell, see a cancer cell, and then start that process of killing it. It can be an exquisite specificity, and that's the definition of personalized therapy. No other patient in the world will get their particular therapy.